tell you, how many single people are there today, huh? Single? Are you looking? Are you looking for somebody? The pens? The diapers? What are you doing?
Loud blast of withdrawing bolts. sadly knew all the guards by now. This one was McGregor. Not a bad guy. He was holding George Halas by the arm. Halas's hands were free, but a steel snake of chain rattled along the floor between the ankles. There was a wide leather belt around the waist of his orange prison jumper, and when he sat down on his side of the glass, McGregor clipped another chain from the steel loop on the belt to a steel loop on the back of the chair. He locked it, gave it a tug, then tipped Bradley a two-finger salute. Afternoon, Master. Afternoon, Mr. McGregor. Alice said nothing. You know the deal, McGregor said. As long as you want today, or as long as you can take him, at the least. I know. Ordinarily, lawyer-client consultations were limited to an hour. Beginning a month before the client's scheduled trip into the room with the Y-shaped table, consultation time was upped to 90 minutes, during which the lawyer and his increasingly squirrely partner in the state-mandated death waltz would discuss a diminishing number of shitty options. During the last week, there was no set time limit. This was true for close relatives as well as legal counsel, but Halas's wife had divorced him only weeks after his conviction and a remote show. He was alone in the world except for Len Bradley. It seemed to want little to do with any of the appeals and the consequent delays Bradley had suggested. Until today, that was. "He'll talk to you," McGregor had told him, after a brief 10-minute consultation the month before, when the Halas's end of the conversation had mostly been no. 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 "When it gets close, he'll talk to you plenty. They get scared, see? They forget all about how they wanted to walk into the injection room with their heads up and their shoulders squared. They start figuring out it's not a meeting. They're really gonna die. And then they want to try every appeal in the book." Alice didn't look scared, though. He looked the same as ever. A small man with bad posture, a sallow complexion, thinning hair, and eyes that looked painted on. He didn't want to have a painted